हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी चैप्टर नंबर 3 फ्रॉम द बुक एन एलियन हैंड फॉर ग्रेड 7th. सो द नेम ऑफ आर चैप्टर इज द डेजर्ट. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द चैप्टर. दोज ऑफ अस हु लिव इन रीजन्स कवर्ड विद फॉरेस्ट. The people who lived in regions that are covered with forest and surrounded by hills may find it difficult to imagine what a desert is really like. So, the people who live in forest areas and hilly areas, they find it difficult that what is a desert really like. The popular belief is that it is an endless stretch of sand. Here a word comes, stretch. Stretch means extend. So some people believe that desert is an endless stretch of sand, that there is a lot of sand everywhere where no rain falls and lack of rains is here, and therefore no vegetation grows. Vegetation is, you can see the word vegetation. What is the meaning of vegetation? Vegetations are plants considered collectively, especially those found in a particular area of or habitat. So some people thinks that desert is the area that is an endless stretch of sand and there is no rainfalls and no vegetations. It is dry and hot. It is very dry, hot, waterless and without shelter. But this is not entirely correct. Here a word comes, entirely. Entirely means completely. So it is not completely correct. For those who have studied it, the desert can be a beautiful place. Some people thinks that desert is only full of sand, but if you studied it, you can find it a beautiful place. It is the home of a variety of people, animals and plants that have learned to live under very hot and dry conditions. Desert is the home of a variety of peoples, animals and plants that are live under very hot and dry conditions. True, the ground is not always hidden by a cover of grass, plants and trees and is and other climates. So desert is not always covered with a grass and plants and trees, but when in desert there rain falls, which is rare. In desert rain is very rare. Desert flowers bloom. Here a word comes, bloom. Bloom is open, means when flowers they open, and the sight can be as rewarding as that of any tropical garden. So when their rare rains come, so flowers bloom and we can say them tropical garden. A desert is not always a flat, unchanging wasteland of dry sand. A desert is not always a flat and there is not only wasteland of sand always. It may have mountains and hills. A desert can have also mountains and hills. It may have an oasis. An oasis is a small area in a desert where water and plants are found. An oasis is like a green island in the middle of a desert. Where a spring or a well gives plants and trees a better chance to grow. A desert may be hot like the Thar and cold like the Ladakh. Here, Thar and Ladakh. Thar is the most hot desert and Ladakh is the most cold desert. So a desert can be hot and cold like Thar and Ladakh. But generally speaking, if a place has little or no water and vegetation, people usually call it a desert. People usually call a desert a place whenever the place that has no water and vegetation, no trees. Some deserts are almost totally without water. Some deserts are totally without water. We cannot find water here. In such places, strong winds blow, raising heaps of sand. Heaps means collection of sand. When winds blows, the sand comes in heaps position. कंडीशन, हीप्स ऑफ सैंड एंड डिपॉजिटिंग दैम एज माउंट्स. माउंट्स मीन्स अ लार्ज क्वान्टिटी ऑफ समथिंग. सो वैन वाइंड्स ब्लो इट रेजिंग हीप्स ऑफ सैंड एंड बिकेम माउंट्स. दीज आर कोल्ड सैंड ड्यून्स. सैंड ड्यून्स मीन्स वैन एवर वाइंड्स ब्लोज देर आर सम सैंड ड्यून्स, सैंड हीप्स लाइक दैट. So these are called sand dunes that shift and move endlessly across the desert. Few plants can survive on such dry shifting sands. Few plants are able to survive on dry and shifting sands. So now we have covered the first part of the desert chapter. Let's move on to the second one. All living things need water in order to survive. All living things like animals, human being and plants need water in order to survive. We all need water. The few plants and animals that live in desert have developed the ability to require less water than most plants and animals. In desert, some plants and some animals have the ability to develop themselves in small water, less small water or without water. They can live without water. The camel, popularly known as sheep of the desert. You can see that we use the sheep in the sea. In the same way, the camel is popularly known as the sheep of the desert because we take much help from the camel in the desert. Can drink a lot of water at one time. Camel can drink a lot of water at one time. Camel can do without water for days together. A camel can live without water for many days. The reason is they sweat very little. We sweat because we must keep our body temperature constant. We all sweat. You all know that human beings sweat because we want our temperature constant. We sweat when it gets hot. Human beings sweat when we gets hot condition, and this cools the body. When we sweat, it cools our body. Camels can stand high body temperature. Camel can live with high body temperature. They don't need to sweat and can therefore retain the water they drink for long periods of time. They can retain their water that they drink. They can retain that water that they drink for long periods of time. The smaller desert animals do not drink water. The animals who lived in small deserts, they do not drink water. They burrow underground during the hot day and come out at night to eat. Burrow means a small hole making by animals. So they live in their burrows during the hot day and come out at night to eat. And they come at night to eat something. Some of them eat other animals. Some of the animals eat other animals and get the water need from the moisture of the meat. And they get the water from the meat, from the moisture of the meat of other animals. Others eat plants and seeds and get the water they need from the plant juices. Other animals what eat? They eat plants and seeds and they get water from the plant juices. Desert plants also adapt themselves to the life they had. You can see here a word comes, adapt. What is the meaning of the word adapt? Adapt means change. Desert plants also change themselves to the life they had. Cactus plants store water in their thick stems. Stems means the plants' thick areas. Below areas. Their roots lie close to the surface of the ground and thickly absorb the moisture from the light rain that occasionally fall. And in desert, rain falls occasionally. So they take the moisture from the ground. The major feature of all desert is, of course, the major feature of desert is dryness and variation of temperature. So these are the two major features of desert. First one is dryness and second is temperature. In humid climates, the moisture in the air acts like a blanket. In humid climates, the moisture in the air acts like a blanket and protects the earth's surface from the hot rays of the sun. And it protects the and it moisturized blanket protects the earth from the hot rays of the sun. The absence of this blanket in desert land causes the desert to heat up rapidly during the day and to cool off rapidly at night. And this moisturized blanket is absent from the desert land. So that's why that deserts are very hot rapidly and during the day, but they cool rapidly at the night. So last one we have, deserts are an important part of nature's great plan. As nature's plan, there are a lot of animals, trees, oceans and forests. Deserts are also an important part of nature. They are there like the dense forests. Here a word comes, dense. Dense means thick and heavy. So there are many heavy forests and deep oceans. Just because they are hot and dry, one should not look upon them as useless parts of the earth. Some people think that deserts are hot and dry, so they are not useful for us. But we should not think that deserts are useless parts. These are very important and useful parts of the earth. We should not think that deserts are useless parts because they are hot and dry. So, hope you all have understood this topic. Thank you.